guys, Ken here, your thrifty apprentice, and welcome back to the channel's version of a crafty corner. In today's video, we are making this really cute little mixed media ATC, which stands for Artist Trading Card Journal. It is a whimsical, cute little thing that is a true mixture of the art journal and mixed media side and the junk journal and side. So without any further ado, I'm going to show you guys how I made this really cute little artist trading card journal. I am starting off here with ink tints in order to do this mixed media background. I'm using a yellow, and I'm going to be using a magenta looking color. I'm going to be using a teal, and then I'm going to also be using ultramarine blue. Now, I just gave those particular names because just in case you're not using this set of pencils, I wanted you to be able to kind of gauge what colors to use. So you see I've put down the yellow, the magenta, the sort of tealy green color. And then I'm going to just fill the entire paper in with those, scribbling back and forth in whatever design pattern you choose if you do this. I kind of wanted something really colorful and bright and beautiful. So I just outlined the edges of the paper with the ultramarine blue. Now, using a spray bottle and a synthetic flat brush, I'm going to activate each individual color one at a time. So I started with the magenta, and from the magenta, I'm going to move into doing the yellow. And what I'm trying to do is give the ink tints time to sit in the paper before I try to blend them all together so that I wouldn't get mud, and I didn't want to lose being able to see each individual color. So I sprayed it with water for a second time, and now you see here I'm just trying to blend whatever pigment is left on the paper together. After giving that time to dry, I'm going to go in with, this is a baby white. That's the technique that I picked up from some videos that I've been watching lately. Just kind of wiping through the stencil, and it actually does remove a little bit of that ink tints. Now, I am doing this project on Canson Artist Series Mixed Media 138 pound cold press paper, I believe it is. It's an okay mixed media paper. I am not all that crazy about it. I figured it'd be really good in this project. Being 138 pounds, it would be sort of thin enough. Now, after I wiped through that stencil, you can see I sort of got this white dot layer without having to use any paint. So that's a great technique if you ever try like making your own patterns and backgrounds. Now I'm using a stamp that I put together. These sentiments, it's like a bouquet for you and all these things, but you're not gonna really be able to read. It's just there for background texture. Now I'm grabbing my final stencil here, and now I'm going to actually use black acrylic paint and put this pattern over the entire paper, and then take that acrylic paint and edge. Just putting it on the edge there. Giving it a frame. I kind of love the way that this came out. Afterwards, I decided that maybe the black was a little too stark, so I was going to try to break it up a little bit. I used a dragonfly stamp with some silver pigment ink. And then I'm going to go in with a sunflower stamp with white pigment ink. I felt like that kind of helped break that black up some, and just to give a little bit more texture to the overall. I knew I was folding this into a mini-zine to turn it into an ATC journal. So I wanted to make sure that each page would have some of the design on it. Those outline stamps are really great for this because they don't completely block out the black. You can see through the stamp. I really like that effect. And then I just re-edged just to be sure. I'm going to let it dry, and then I'm going to spray it with a fixative. It is very important that you let it dry first, then spray it with a fixative, and let the fixative completely dry as well before moving on. Once that was done, it was time to fold the project so that we can create the little journal. This is only going to be one page. I think this is a really neat design. It's an ideal spin off of a mixed media meeting thing. So you fold it in half the hamburger way, then you fold it in half the hot dog way. Make sure you get some pretty good creases so you can see where you're going. After that, open it up, and then you're going to fold each end into that middle fold. I tried to make sure that you could see exactly what was going, so I fold in the right side, and I flip my paper around and fold in the left side because I work better with my right hand. It's just thing. You do whatever is best for you. And then I'm just going to crease it back and forth, making sure all those folds are really good. Open it up, fold it back the hamburger way, and then you're going to cut in the middle through only one panel. So you're going to cut up through one panel, not through the second. Be careful there. After that, you'll open up the paper, and then you're going to turn it the opposite landscape way, or pull it and push. Fold it down. There, you've created your little journal. I'm going to get it creased really well. Front and back cover kind of even with the rest of the journal. And as you can see, it makes a little mini zine. Now I'm going to open this back up so that I can glue these pages together. So that as you turn, you won't be able to see the inside. Now I guess you could probably make a pocket out of one of these if you wanted to, but that was not the design that I had in mind. So I put some super strength glue using my glue stick down, and then I refolded the mini zine. First, the two pieces on the end, getting them lined up because I want to try to have this even as possible. Afterwards, I'm going to pick it up, push in there, it'll stick. Now, I'm just going to make sure that each one of those pages are glued down. Use a bone folder, use whatever you may normally use in order to make sure that your pages are down. Go in with some more glue if you need to, if it's lifting in any areas. I go into my creases just to make sure, you know, that it's going to fold properly. I bone fold each page and then the front and the back. Now, it does take a little maneuvering in order to get it completely even. Keep in mind that, you know, paper doesn't stretch, and we have folded it a lot of different ways here. So just take your time and work with it. It will eventually work itself into place. Really neat little design, whoever came up with this, because this design, of course, is not an original idea. Whoever came up with this, this was really neat and inventive. I thought it was really cute. So after getting it made, I needed to push it a step further. We need this to be an ATC journal. So here's what I do. And from all of that, we have this. Here we have a mixed media mini zine. It is a 9x12 piece of paper that has been folded down into a booklet. That is so cute to me. I love the ink tints colors, so bright and beautiful through that bold black print. So now what you do with this at this point is completely on you. You can use it for a little art journaling booklet and actually art journal on each page or each section. You can do it in sections if that's what you choose to do. Me personally, I am going to do a little bit more decoration to it with ephemera in order to make it a booklet that can be added into either an art journal or a junk journal. What I'll be using is cutouts from a digi kit I created. So lately I've been working on, or you know, digital package that I created. Lately I've been working on, you know, creating packages that I'll be able to have available digitally for people who may want them. And this is one of the first ones that I created. I did search for the images in order to put all of these together. And I decided that since this was my prototype kit, I was going to be using it in order to decorate this booklet. I've already cut those out. And I'm going to be gluing these down to this piece of file folder in order to give them some backing. So here I have glued all of my magazine pieces down to file folder. I inked around some of them. Some of them I've sewn around. They have little journaling cards on the back there. And the cover, I've sewn around that one as well. So now I'm just going to glue those down. I'll just go over that with my bone folder to make sure that I have it adhered down. And there we have the cover. Really cute, really cute, really cute. Now I'm going to take time to glue each one of these down to create a tuck spot on the inside of each page. So I'll just glue in an L and put each one of these down on the page. Yeah, we'll just get that down in that L. I'm going to use my napkin so I can catch any glue. And of course, you guys saw that I'm using Fabri-Fix. There, we have that. So I'm just going to go through and glue the rest of them in to the booklet. Here we are with our mini journal complete. Just a little quick flip through to show you. I just made L pockets out of all of these in order to stick tags and things in. And that completes our little booklet, guys. I think they are so cute. Really, really love them. So now I'm going to fill it. And then we'll come back for a final flip through of this little cute mini journal. Here we are with our completed journal. I have gone through and decorated the journal. And I also added a little yarn tie to it. I just took a couple pieces of yarn and braided them together in order to create this string and made a bow on the front of the little journal so that, you know, it'll have a little pizzazz. I think it adds some cuteness to it, especially with the green and the mixed media background. So if as much as you wanted to see what's the construction of the journal, thank you so very much. For those who want to see the flip through, it's going to be very straightforward and simple. This is an artist trading card journal. So I simply opted to put artist trading card size sheets of mixed media paper inside each of the tucks. So you're gonna get a 3.5 by 2.5 piece of mixed media paper so that you can create your own mixed media artist trading cards. Which are a trend among artists. You can tuck as many pieces of paper in your little journal as you want to. You can tuck tags, you can tuck ephemera if you're putting it into a junk journal, whatever the case may be. I just chose to tuck artist trading card size mixed media cutouts or in here since it is a ATC journal. So there you have it, guys. Not as complicated as it may have looked from the beginning. It is a true blend, as I told you, between mixed media and junk journaling. I really, really like this. I'm going to make many, many more of these. They'll make wonderful little gifts. They'll make wonderful little additions into journals. Just really quickly, before we, you know, can't get that bow right. I'll get that bow back later. But really quickly, let me show you how to tuck in a journal. So I just happened to have this journal out because I was working on the final touches to it. It is almost ready for market. But let me just show you guys what I mean. I'll just slide this out here really quickly so I can show you. You know, it can just tuck right inside your journal. It'll be a lovely little addition inside a journal. And just close in and wrap around, especially if your journal is made of cloth like this one is. Like, that would be really, really nice. Really nice. So, yeah, guys, there you have it. There is the Mixed Media ATC Artist Trading Card Journal. I hope you guys picked up on some tips, tricks, or techniques that you like, that you found the journal, something that you like. If you did, don't forget to give the video a thumbs up. Remember, that helps the channel. Share the video. Sharing is caring. And maybe someone out there would love to know this information. Go ahead and hit us up on the Thrifty Apprentice Facebook page, Instagram, and TikTok. You can join the Facebook group, Paints, Pencils, Pastels, and Markers, where we do all things artsy and crafty. Really love the people over there. They're cool. And there's some constant posting, and there's some engagement, you know. So it's not just, it's starting to pick up, and I really love that. Anything else? No. You know, guys, and remember, as I tell you at the end of every single video, until next Sunday, just keep painting and crafting.